收购因为太慢。We are going to talk about some information technology, semiconductor, etc. Not too technical. We are going to go through maybe in general, what's in Taiwan. It's information engineering or computer science or semiconductor roughly. Digital Taiwan and technology and evolution. Okay, so in case you don't know what's in Taiwan, we start from we can go from a three step. The first step is e-Taiwan. The e-Taiwan or m-Taiwan or u-Taiwan also apply to different country, like maybe Japan, m-Japan or u-Japan. Actually, all this technology also fit to some other country. How many students from Japan? Any student from Japan? You? One? You from Tokyo?
Yeah.
Okay. Not around Tohoku University. Sendai. How far away from Sendai? Sendai. The earthquake. March 11. How far away?
I don't know.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's around 200-300 kilometers away. Okay, so I will explain what's e-Taiwan. Means electronics. And app, we move made a progress. Then become a mobile Taiwan, and then right now we try to have some new technology, try to make Taiwan become ubiquitous Taiwan. Anybody more than 25 years old? You, okay, 25 years old. That's mean when you are a kid, do you have a computer? When you were in primary school, did you use a computer?
BMD.
What's that?
Computer.
It's not an IBM computer?
No.
Okay, it's a low level or simple, very simple computer, yeah. Yeah, when Apple company or IBM launch their first personal computer, about what time? Do you know?
90s.
What?
90s.
Late 1970. So around 1980, have you heard about Apple II computer? Apple II, that's very old, right? I had one. I had one when I was in United States. I bought one Apple II computer, and it cost me $3,000 or $4,000. Very expensive, very expensive. Around 1980 or 1981, IBM company launched their first IBM PC. Around 1980 or 1981, roughly. When I was in the United States, my advisor bought one complete set of IBM PC. It cost $10,000 or $10,000. So for a simple, very simple personal computer, very, very expensive that time, around 30 years old, 30 years ago. So the first personal computer, like you can buy a car, $10,000. When I was in the United States, maybe one small Japanese car That's cost about 5,000 or 6,000 US dollars. But the one person computer cost $10,000. So actually in 1980, so very few people had computer system. So what they do when they want to do some business, want to do a communication? By telephone, right? Not a mobile, not by mobile or smartphone, by telephone only, or by fax, or very expensive, or fax. So around 1990, roughly, people start to use so-called internet around 1990. So send an email, maybe from Taiwan to United States, or from Taiwan to Germany, or from Taiwan to Japan. Yeah. So anybody see modem, so-called modem? Yeah. In the old days, made for you an old guy. So we in the telephone, then there's a so-called modem. So the telephone system goes to modem, then to make it to the brain. Then you do some computation because you don't have computer system. It's so expensive. So you use maybe you have a so-called terminal. Then you have one terminal. You dial go to a modem, dial connect to a mainframe for maybe this university. Then you get some result and send back. After that, around 1990, the window, we start to have IE, so-called internet, Internet Explorer. So around 1990, people always stay in the office or in the lab. Then use the internet or use the telephone for fax machine to do some business. Then after that, from 1990, after that, we stop to have so-called, you can get you can access the information to your mobile device, like a PDA, like your smartphone, or like your a notebook, right? Notebook. So actually, but we spend many years without a phone, no computer system, then we have the so-called electronic system, or e-Taiwan, we so-called. So then after that, right now we can access any information for your mobile device. Anybody have a HTC mobile phone? You have one? What kind of name? HTC. Anybody has an Apple iPhone? You? And right now, many smartphones you can access. Can you access to NTU wireless internet? Right? You can access. You can go to Wi-Fi, right? Or from a 3G system, if you're outside. Such as if you are in, right now, if you are in Taipei 101, there's no Wi-Fi. You can access the internet, or you can get the email through Wi-Fi. And actually, you can do a business. Suppose you are here. You want to do some business with some people in United States. You can make a phone call or write an email to him, to the person in United States. Yeah. What?
They're sleeping now.
Oh, okay. Maybe in Europe. Yeah, in Europe. Now we are 4 o'clock, right? So we are in Paris. It's at 9 a.m. 9 or 10 a.m. When you are doing some business, sometimes you don't sleep. Sometimes you don't sleep. Such as if you are working in a shoes, and maybe your colleague, maybe in working in the Silicon Valley, he is waiting for your response. So he will not sleep. Okay, so then we are going to have ubiquitous, so-called, is an even more advanced system. Now we can see something from the video. Okay, so-called ambitions, we can get, you can access office document, email, contract, calendar, or voice map, or voice, or some information through your mobile device. Okay. It's let's go back to e-Taiwan. So it's a war before computer desk. So when you are in your office or in your lab, you can access many information through the internet. So means electronic or digital. We can acquire or share information by internet. It's a meta is very popular to use Google, right? So you just go to Google and type iStep, or you can go to MIT. MIT, you can access some MIT courseware. They have a like a course note, or maybe a video. You can go to MIT. They have maybe around more than 50 courses. Courses material. So it's maybe the first step. We can access information from your office, or your lab, or your home. You sit maybe in front of a table, in front of your computer. Then we can move to so-called M means mobile. So you can get email or any information, contacts, etc. So it's a second step. Okay, here is an example. We are going to see this one. This one, a museum. So when you visit the museum, you can get information. Such as if you go to a National Palace Museum, okay, you see a China, some antique, and you can get some information from your PDA. And here is another system. It's an aquarium in Pingdong. Anybody have been to Southern Taiwan? Pingdong? No? It's a Pingdong Marine Biology and Aquarium. It's a very best aquarium in Eastern Asia. You should go there. Okay, we are going to see the museum later in the film. So actually you can use a PDA. You go to some place and you can get some information from your PDA. Last summer, about 1 month ago, I went to the United States. I went to one museum. They give me like a device, like a something like a walkie talkie, and some number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, something like that.
and then you go someplace, say some explanation, you can listen to some voice explanation. Okay, maybe a number five. So you just switch to number five channel, then you get some explanation or voice explanation for number five position. Then if you go to the other place, maybe a number six, you can get some voice some voice explanation. But all here PDA, you can get voice and also visual or some picture of even a video. Okay, we are going to see this one later. And this museum is also very good. You should go there. You should go to visit sometime. So you can have some information by PDA or by something like bigger one, like a notebook. Or right now we use iPad, bigger, even bigger. Okay, here is something like a PDA. This one is a PDA. Okay, another one. Do you have this one? Smart car. It's when you take a subway. Do you have this one? Student ID, right? Actually, we combine. Like I also have. You have? You have student? Yeah, I have. I don't have. It's a faculty ID. Yeah, for me. But this side is, I can take this one to take a subway. Similar to yours, right?
But we have the discount, you don't have the discount.
I also get some discount. What's inside? What's inside this so-called smart, actually, this one is a kind of smart car. What's inside? Do you know that? Let me show you another chip. This car is a post office. You want to get money, access to the post office. You have some account and you want to get set like $1,000 from the banking machine. You can see here. Can you see? This is smart. This is one chip. Can you see this one? It's very similar to your SIM car. Like the one inside your mobile phone. This one is just like a SIM card. It's actually called a smart chip. And some company, several company in Taiwan made this one. And they try to promote for some other system like a credit card. Many credit card, right now they use a barcode. But they want to change to this so-called smart card. So actually inside this one, there's one, if you want, after you go back to your country, you can cut it, and you can see what's inside. Okay, so right now, what we can do by using this so-called smart car? Means anytime, anywhere, any service, any device, and all security. It's one example for so-called liquids. So actually, right now, such as a long time, like 10 years ago, when you go to supermarket, you maybe you take 10 items, and then you go out to the counter, right? The clerk, how they charge you? How the when you go, how you pay? How did you pay? How do they count how much money you should pay? And 10 or maybe long earlier. They check like this one is $2.99, right? They punch $2.99, something like that, right? Then next one, this item is 599, then key 599. Then later on, we have a so-called scanning system. There are some barcode. So use like a gun scan. Like a gun with a red light scanning system. Scan like a what first item maybe 299, second item maybe 399, something like that. Then finally give you a bill. Then can we improve this system?
Can we use like NFC technology in your communication chips, so you can just put the item on a sensor and communicate with the
children
with the item and
see
the price.
Yeah, right now they are doing some easier and faster way. So they are trying to put some single chip for each item. Maybe you buy one bottle of Coca-Cola, maybe you buy one milk or something like that. Okay, we are going to see in the film. Like when you want to borrow some books from the library, you just take a book, you don't need to go to the librarian. Librarian has to rent to if you a car or like you want to borrow three books, you don't need to write anything. Okay.
Okay, here is AP. Why is AP? Actually, we have one or two over here in this room. Let me see. Over here. Yeah. That's behind this table. Over here. Yeah. Why is AP? In Taiwan, it's very convenient. Yeah. When you go to one hotel, you can always access to the internet and free. And fast, very fast. But when you go to last time I went to 2 years ago, I went to Paris. Anyone from France? Two, right? I should pay internet like €5 for first 1 hour, right? And then €8 for 2 hours. Then €10 for whole day, something like that. It's not free. When you check in one hotel, it's redundant or extra cost. Okay, so you know what is? When you take a bus, right? You can use this smart card. Then you put. Then you pay the money. So actually it's a new, Taiwan is trying to do some other thing automatically or by new technology. Okay, and over here is a so-called RFID, radio frequency identification, RFID, another one, RFID. It's just like as I mentioned earlier, if you take three books from the library, you just take a book and go out. You don't need to fill anything. And so they use so-called RFID technology. Okay, so yeah, later. We are going to see in the video. It's an open book library, or so-called intelligent library powered by RFID. Just take maybe three books or five books, and then go through this gate. Then the computer will decode which book, the first book. What's the book name? And the second book, the book name, the author, or something like that.
maybe Facebook, Facebook, Facebook. You just go out. And the SaaS, some healthcare. We are going to see later. Okay, it's an NTU hospital. Taiwan, actually many other countries, like Japan or United States, they are trying to do some new home care system by internet. We are actually like in our research, we are trying to do some sensor, like a blood test or sensor, or like a blood pressure or sensor, something like that. So once the sensor feel okay, one patient has something wrong, then they will notify the hospital or their family. Okay, we are going to talk about this maybe sometime later. It's a new so-called hospital system. Okay, about 5 years ago, 5 years ago, 2006, was these few items Taiwan made the most in the world. The product or technique Taiwan first place in the world like a notebook. The market, 83% of notebook made in Taiwan. Do you know which company is the biggest company in the world selling a notebook computer? As is first in Europe, not in the world. Yeah, from France, right? Yeah. Yeah, Acer is they have the biggest market share in Europe, but in the world, which company is the first one?
I think it's Dell.
Dell.
HP.
HP. HP is the first one. No. They sell the most. HP sell most notebook computer in the world. But who made the computer for HP? Taiwan. some Yeda in Chinese, Yeda or Guangda. They made.
What is TMT?
I will explain later. Okay, so HP is the biggest company selling a notebook computer. Acer was second or third, but right now Acer is in bad shape right now, last few months. So right now they drop maybe to third or fourth place. TFT LCD is the same thing. Same theme or transistor or LCD. LCD is a display. The monitor. The monitor in notebook or your desktop computer. Same theme. Same theme transistor or liquid crystal display. Not only the display, also TV. 32-inch or 46 or 55 market share 45%. This means actually TV, this one LCD monitor, a smaller one, a smaller size. Foundry is for wafer, foundry. They are making a wafer for semiconductor and a motherboard. These are the Taiwan make most, but the profit is quite low. So they try to make as many as possible, like 10 million, like when they make one model, they try to sell 1 million notebook, or 5 million. Okay, so, okay, and let's watch a video.
是被美国智库智慧社区论坛选为2006年全世界最聪明的城市，它有多聪明？开车找停车位没问题，电子告示板可以一口气告诉你这附近所有停车场还有多少个停车位，你不必担心故意把车子停远一点，到了电影院才发现。天哪，还有136个停车格等着你。等公车吗？红32号3分钟之后就进站了。但如果你等的是蓝27，抱歉，37分钟之后才会到。赶约会的话，就得考虑换其他交通工具了。小小的设计，生活却大大的便利。
就有时候会等很久啊，然后要等的都不来，然后不等的就一直来啊。对，那我觉得现在有这个看板还蛮方便的。
哦，它上面还绣得蛮清楚的，然后时间蛮快的，这样
所以有帮助，帮助很大。
是啊，帮助很大。
停车费老师忘了缴，30块变成600块罚单，别担心，手机也可以缴费。在这个聪明的城市，结婚登记不必亲自跑户政事务所，家里就可以上网办理。报税也不必再排队等候，网络报税，电脑自动帮你计算不同的节税方案。家里有小孩，担心肠病毒感染，没问题，网络上有最新的传染病分布状况，生活所有资讯全部一网打尽。
有一个这个健康网，那么平常我们民众呢在平常就可以做保健，如果有一些健康的需要啦，或者健康的尝试，那么想知道的话，就可以上市民健康网。台北市网络新都计划呢，那么主要的内容有包括了基础建设，那基础建设主要是说把这个整个城市包括无线网络，那么能够呢把它建起来，让整个市民呢，不管你到什么地方呢，都能够很容易的上网，把市民的电子化生活能够融进我们整个的建设里面。那让市民几乎呢整天，当我们碰到有一些生活上的需要的时候，那么就可以透过这样一个网络，那么可以得到市政府的服务。
一化的台湾秀出了台湾的高科技水准，以让台湾民众的生活更科技。
No, it's on the other side of that screen is someone in funny brown shorts. Okay. See the Papa John's pizza truck go by? Guess who's driving?Say it with me now. Someone in funny brown shorts, okay?
他是畅销书《世界是平等》的作者汤马斯·弗里曼，也是美国公认最有影响力的新闻工作者。同时，他还是普利兹奖终身评审以及哈佛大学的客座教授。要听这位趋势大师精彩的演说，不必到哈佛，电脑桌前就可以欣赏他幽默的一面。
那你最多只能看他的书，接受一些二手的资讯。但现在当我们把这些知识通通都引进到台湾的时候，其实你可以不花分文，你就上网去 download 这些影片，去亲自听听看这些大师到底是怎么样介绍他们的人生，或者怎么样介绍他们新的理念。那这些影片都是免费 download 的，你只要有时间你可以把它全部看完的话，其实等于是你实际到麻省理工学院走了一趟，听了一个大师的演讲。
自称是公有的朱学恒，是台湾引进开放式课程的关键人物。所谓开放式课程，里头网罗了麻省理工学院、约翰霍普金斯大学、剑桥大学等等世界知名的上课内容。1500门课程透过网络，知识随手可得。
其实开放式课程是目前世界上的一个新的趋势啊，它大概是在2002年的时候，由麻省理工学院率先推出来的一个开放式的知识分享计划。 所以整个在中文化的课程里面大概有将近1500门，是包括了从他的史龙管理学院，从他的这个电机与资工相关的课程、核子工程、飞航课程，大概有34个不同的科系的所有资源，甚至他现在最新上线的是包括了学校的这个体育运动与娱乐科系，所以里面有包括了击剑，有包括了射箭，有包括了重量训练。哎，他是现在世界上的一些顶尖大学的一个知识分享的潮流。
一画让你在电脑桌前分享世界 ，M 画则是让你走到哪都可以分享世界。M 台湾也就是行动台湾，是一画台湾的再升级。
一台湾讲的就是电子化的部分，那进一步到 M 台湾，这个 M 就是 mobile。M 台湾呢、啊，我们翻成行动台湾，意思就是说我们要做通讯的时候呢，是可以移动的来做通讯。那 M 台湾是把台湾的整个环境，一个我们叫做无线的，它特别强调一个无线的，另外一个很重要的建设就是要做到宽频。那么因为无线的，所以你其实你通讯的工具是可以移动的，那么因为是宽频，所以将来不只是声音，而且文字，而且数据影像都可以来传输。所以强调 M 台湾就强调不管在任何的地方，在任何的人用任何的工具都可以来联系。
行动台湾是政府目前积极推动的新政策，它主要有两大部分，内政部300亿经费负责铺设全岛网路，经济部则是专职在企业技术的运用。到底什么是 M 台湾行动台湾呢？
第一个，水温不能太高，大概是要20度以下，所以我们这边的水温，小朋友请问我们控制在几度？
这里是屏东的海洋生物博物馆，传统的解说方式是解说员在定点负责讲解。
在每一个比较大的展示缸里面，前面它会有一些驻点人员，那么他就看游客来的时候，他就随时拿起这个麦克风来做一些解说。可是事实上我们来的游客一年平均大概有200万人啊，所以他事实上没有办法去满足每一个人。游客的调查发现就是说，其实有30%的人他希望来这边可以借这个机会呢，借在旅游的机会呢，得到一些有关于海洋教育生活的知识。可是往往在这个情况下呢，大部分都是凭着这个走马看花啦，有时候看看那个牌子，有时候看看那个放的影片，得到一些片段的知识，那其实这个是蛮可惜的。
现在海生馆建立了全球第一套博物馆行动导览，民众只要拿着 PDA 走到哪，知识就跟到哪，这就是行动台湾的最佳代表作。
我们来看看使用 PDA， 它以前是鸟类的一种，那一直到65万年前为了适应水中的生活才慢慢的演化的。那全世界总共有17种企鹅，它最快的时速都可以达到20至30公里。
哇，那好快哦。
对啊，它叫好鹦鹉。到底在北极还是南极？它会飞啊，可是飞不高。
只要点选海洋区域，再继续点选你想知道的动物种类，所有资讯全部秀出来。
海鹦鹉一生当中大多数的时间都是在海上度过的，每年只有4到8月的时候才会飞到小岛或是沿海的峭壁上面筑巢繁殖。
我们在海生馆这里面呢，大概所有的展区里面布建了有60颗的 AP， 那就是无线的接收器。那事实上在这个行动导览的服务里面呢，因为它是透过即时的网络传输，所以事实上民众可以从这里面获得的知识非常多。它是透过所谓刚刚讲的 AP 层下去做定位，那当民众呢，只要你拿着你的 PDA， 然后你到了这一个展示的主题跟这个 AP 做沟通之后呢，它就会告诉你你现在的所在位置是在什么地方，那会主动的提示你，比如说你走到了小白鲸的展示区，它就会告诉你说你现在的所在位置是小白鲸。然后我们除了在这导览里面所提供的内容之外，我们有后端的资料库，也连接到海生馆非常丰富的一个学习的资源资料。所以比如说你到了小白鲸缸，你想了解小白鲸的一个习性， 知道它的敌人，知道它的食物，然后你也可以从比如说小白鲸的敌人是那个北极熊，那你也可以从资料库里面再去更深入的去了解北极熊的一些相关的特性。所以事实上这个部分的学习，因为它是透过网络，事实上它学习的内容是无远佛界的。
当一个无线装置在被使用的时候，由于它内容可以随时被更新的时候，其实你的教育内容的品质不再仅止于你所看到的内容，它可以随时被更新，它随时可以连到不同的资料库，提供依照顾客自己的需求跟学习的动机的强弱来决定他学习的内容的多寡。其实在本身在技术上，在无线的技术，在通讯技术，在网际网络的技术，甚至写程式的技术上是不足为奇，其实大家都会写，但是如何把科技用在生活里面，让生活更有趣味性，这是海生馆愿意尝试的地方。
科技无所不在，知识也就随手可得。台湾懂得发展科技，运用科技，更知道怎么利用科技来让台湾成为真正的科技与地岛。
装上市了耶，你今天下班陪我去买逛一逛好不好？
啊，要去逛街哦？我想一下哦。啊，我跟你说啊，我刚下班之前才上网查过，现在路上好塞哦。
很塞？
来自台北市交通大队的消息。
可是我用我的双网手机查交通即时路况，顺畅得很啊。
啊，交通顺畅哦，哎。这个嘛，哎，老婆，我刚刚用手机连回家里面看了一下，厨房有人在烧水，可是我没看见玛丽亚哎。我先回家看一下到底怎么回事啊。
烧开水。老公，你放心，我正看着玛丽亚进厨房呢。别忘了，我用的可是双网手机哦。
这不是电影情节虚拟的世界，而是台湾目前正在发展的双网环境。简单的说，就是无线网络加上手机网络。由于无线网络频宽够，可以下载影像，而手机网络行动方便，走到哪通到哪。双网结合之后所创造出来的生活环境，既先进又科技。
双网计划它的最早的构想是说，我们看到有两个网络跟我们的生活息息相关。这两个网络，一个网络就是大家都知道我们平常用的行动电话的网络，另外网络其实一般是电脑在用，就是所谓的无线的区域网络，或者称为 WiFi， 把这两个网络呢把它整合在一起。怎么整合呢？第一步是做一个特殊的手机，这个手机呢除了一般打电话以外，也可以连上这个 WiFi， 就是电脑的网络上面。所以你如果把东西做到手机上的话，你出门就可以一样可以用。
全球消费者使用的无线区域网络设备当中，有九成是台湾制造的，再加上台湾的行动电话普及率是110%，两项台湾都是全球第一。所以建制双网环境，台湾拥有得天独厚的优秀条件。
Let me see, you can get some Chinese edition of the film or the video. Okay, if you go to a national applied research lab, the website, you can get some video, but it's only in Chinese, voice or and no English caption. We add English caption. By using the video they gave to us. So actually I think the film, I think short of maybe 3-5 minutes. So you can get, you can go to the website to finish this video. Okay, so anybody drive in Taiwan? Drive a car in Taiwan? No? Okay. In the film, So such as if I drive my car to 信义啊near 信义区啊near 台北 101, because there are several parking space, and actually the Taipei government Taipei city government they build some digital board digital you can see how many parking space maybe some one parking lot maybe another maybe 50 parking space another parking lot now become much more convenient before you go you don't want to go to a parking lot and you wait maybe 1 hour and right now when I drive in the highway when I drive like from Taipei to 台中 I sometimes I can see some announcement maybe maybe after another 10 kilometer there is one accident there will be a traffic jam something like that and actually you can see a traffic condition from your smartphone you can access to you have Apple computer you can download APP program you can check the traffic condition like a highway like a highway 1 or highway 3 or something like that you can check can you pay tax through the internet? Anybody pay tax? File your tax report. Did you file your tax report? Do you need to pay tax? Do you need to pay extra tax? Or you can get some pay tax and get some money back.
It's really convenient because you don't have to go there or something. You can just, you need a number for that, so you have to register first. Then you can just do it from the online. You don't need to send any stuff over there.
Okay. Yeah, in Taiwan, yeah, maybe after you get a job, you have a salary, then you need to pay tax, right? Then you just you can download your income through the internet from the government website and file some how much money you want to exam like how many member in your family like you and your wife or your husband or something or you have 2 kids or 3 kids you have a family of 5 then how many exemption how much money you can exempt maybe you buy a house how many how much money that you pay interest for your house loan right so you can file you can file a tax report from the internet you don't need to you don't need to send a report by mail or you go you don't need to go to the IRA right IRA in the United States anybody still use mail send still go to post office and you send a mail to your father or to your friend like in Germany or in United States? Yeah. okay. You know, last week I I did one from the internet. US post office is almost bankrupt, right? Yeah, they are going to fire. They are going to fire maybe I don't know 10,000 or 20,000 staff. because right now more and more people use the internet. They don't need to send a letter by mail or send a package or document. So what you can do? The post office can make money if you don't send a mail? Yeah, so they should try to do something, right? Like in Taiwan, or Taiwan's post office making a lot of money. Yeah, because Taiwan's post office, you can put the money, you can get it, they can earn some interest. It's just like a bank. But in the States, post office, you cannot deposit money, your money in the post office. But in Taiwan, you put your money inside the post office, and the post office lend the money to some other people with a higher interest rate. And they also sell many stuff, right? Taiwan post office make a lot of money. Yeah, so maybe United States should send some people to come to Taiwan, learn from Taiwan. Okay. Yeah, so from concerning today's topic, I want to mention, this is not today's. Yeah, I want to mention this part again. This one is the number one product in the world. From Taiwan, like a notebook, the market share more than 80%, and LCD TV more than 40%, yeah, maybe 40-45%. Monitor is more than 75%. Right now, I don't know. You can go to a website. Government website, you can get the latest or update or information. Actually, many others. Number one product in Taiwan. So what's we have several students from Germany and from Europe, from France. Germany and France also have a lot of high tech. Can you, anyone from Germany? Yeah, can you give one or two high tech products in Germany?
The Germans are very good in building cars.
Yeah, automobile, right? Making car. Which name brands? The best cars in the world. Porsche, right? Yeah. I wish I had a Porsche. Yeah. It's very expensive and very good. Automobile like Porsche, like Volkswagen, like Mercedes-Benz, like BMW, all German company. But besides automobile, there's one more thing, autobahn, right? When you drive your car in freeway in Germany, there's no speed limit, yeah, right? You can drive, I was in Germany 20 years ago, 1988 or 1989. I drive Volkswagen, as a rabbit, something like that. Then I drive 150 or 160 kilometers per hour. It's very fast. But I saw many cars pass by. BMW maybe drive 180. Benz, maybe drive 200, then another Porsche, 250. Yeah, so, but actually making the highway high speed freeway is a high tech. If you can check. If you go to the website, it's not easy to make a highway. Then you can drive maybe 250 or 300 kilometers per hour. It's not easy. It's much better highway condition. There are many high tech inside for building a highway or so called autobahn. And from Venice, can you name one or two high tech in Venice? Yeah, for your country. For your country.
Perfume?
Perfume, yeah. LV, Prada. You know, this is one airline company or Airbus. Airbus, right? Aviation, yeah, aviation, yeah. That's a, it's a joint company by France and England, yeah. Owned by European. European several country, right? Airbus, right now, airplane is the biggest or largest airplane in the world. Yeah, Airbus A380 is the largest airplane. Is a how many people can sit in inside the A380? 500.
Depends on the world, but I think until 800 are possible, but only about 500.
Okay, yeah, you can sit up to 800, but normally 300 between 300 and 400, yeah, because of the first class, the cabinet. The cabinet for first class is very luxurious, right? Yeah. You can sleep inside.
I've seen a restaurant, Airbus A80,
a
restaurant,
like
just next room.
Restaurant,
Airbus 380.
Yeah, there's a restaurant in Taiwan, they designed it to look like inside
the building. Oh, really? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I don't know how many of you are going to stay, and maybe after you finish your degree. And in Taiwan, we have many foreigners like you. Maybe they get a degree, or when you go back to your country and finish your degree, then come to Taiwan again and work in Taiwan, maybe in Taipei or in Hsinchu. Yeah, in Hsinchu, Science Park, there are many foreigners, so-called foreigners, maybe American or Germany or French people, Yeah, we have many, foreign people work in Taiwan, and they get very high pay, very high pay, compared to a regular person. So you can think about it. Maybe after you finish your degree, maybe a bachelor degree or master degree or PhD degree, you can stay in Taiwan, get a job. Okay, and any question?
French technology,
like nuclear technology, it's here. Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. This gentleman is nuclear technology in France. Do you know how many nuclear power plant in France?
I don't know.
About 55, roughly. Yeah. Yeah, 55 nuclear power plant. Roughly. Yeah, actually, yeah, you can go to a website, type how many nuclear power plant in France. right now it's a very convenient to get information. Yeah. Friends. Friends, it's very good in nuclear energy technology. And also, Germany also. Yeah, I know. Germany also very good. Germany also have very a lot of nuclear power plant. Because
Germany has only like 17 left.
17 left?
Yeah,
that's not much. That's it. Do you know how many nuclear power plant in Taiwan?
Four.
Only three in operation. And one, the fourth one, nuclear power plant number four is under construction. Right now. So actually we have three nuclear power plants, two in the northern Taiwan, one in next to Pingdong, this aquarium, the museum. We have only three nuclear power plants, and each power plant we have two sets of a nuclear power plant reactor. So we have six reactors.
How much percent of the electricity of Taiwan is produced by nuclear power plant?
How many percent of energy produced by nuclear power plant? And it depends. Depend on the weather and the time. When you know, you cannot the nuclear power plant should keep working, keep functioning. Yeah. So maybe, but like right now, the temperature is very comfortable, not too hot. So demanding for energy is low down right now. But during the daytime, everybody is turn on the air conditioner. So the demanding for, but the nuclear power plant, so maybe right now, maybe 30% or 40%. But during daytime, they increase the power by oil or gas or coal. For fire, some power plant, maybe they use energy from the oil. So maybe the percentage for nuclear power plant maybe low down maybe 5 to 10%. And right now, Germany is trying to increase the percentage for renewable energy, right? Like a nuclear power plant, solar energy, and some other renewable energy. So maybe some of you can talk about that maybe later. Yeah. Maybe later this semester. Okay, so I asked TA to ask you some question. So please answer his question. Then after the class, go to him and say you answer like a three question. Okay. So now is TA's time. He's going to ask you some question.
Yeah. According to videos, maybe the Taipei City is called the Magnetic City. So can you give some example of why or how it be called as the smart city?
Like you can telecast through internet or mobile phone. So can you give some another examples?
Okay. Can you see how many spaces are left in sparkly
walls? Yes. Okay. And
so like the Bible times?
Yeah, sure.
The wireless environment? What? The wireless environment?
Wireless environment.
Taiwan is creating an e-learning system with lectures online for everyone.
Yes. Okay.
Taiwan is doing some e-learning. Right now we are making a video. After this semester, all the video will be put inside the website. So for the e-learning. So you are going to be a maybe next semester, some other student will see you.
RFID system. And also it can be used in the convenience store. It can be borrowed from the car. Yeah. Okay.
They are working on
2 on
network devices.
sorry. Can you say again?
Advantage of how to say the open source and open cross automized systems, do you know?
See all the masters in their speeches at the UAB University, and you have that sort of advantage.
Yeah, it's one of the advantages. Is there anything else?
The university can collaborate, share information.
Yes, and also,
anyone can think about
it's free. To all of
this
website.
And because of this, go open.
Yeah, it's okay. So, and can you know what's the difference between the wireless and the mobile network? So anyone can differentiate that.
Sorry, excuse me, can you repeat that?
What's the difference between the wireless and the mobile network? There are two systems, different systems.
Is it like the wireless is for like computers in the home or classroom, but the mobile is you can take it with you anywhere?
Yes, that's right.
They're also working on different frequencies, and the mobile frequencies are more for SMS and voice transmitters, and the Wi-Fi is for data and broadband.
Actually, the mobile network is more portable and convenient, and the wireless, it can be with enough bandwidth so you can download large something like images or files, something like that.
Before the new name to TA, after the class. Yeah. So, wait a second. I want to go to our course class schedule. Can the content? Oh yeah, over here. Okay, today. Yeah, today is September 21st. Yeah, so the topic for today's class. Wireless or in Taiwan. Wireless technology in Taiwan. Actually, it applies to many other countries. So such as, if you go back to your country, like Germany, you can have a new company, maybe doing this kind of business. And then you have a smart car company, and you want to do some, like in the supermarket, or like in the library, or maybe in the some school or university. Okay, next week, now we are going to talk about something. Actually, we want to transform transform some high tech technology like aerospace or defense technology to regular industry or conventional industry or improvement for conventional industry. Yeah. Then a week later, we are going to see Taiwan Nano Exhibition near the World Trade Center. So we don't have class that day. So we don't have class October 5th. Then the exhibition will start from 5th. And next day 6th and October 7th, 3 days. So you can go anytime. Maybe you spend maybe 2-3 hours or 1 day if you are interested. You can see some, you can go there and see some new product, some new nanotech product or some new high-tech company in the world. Okay, so then site visit October 26th. So we have around 30 students. So we are going to take maybe we are going to rent a bus. And as I mentioned last week, maybe we leave here around 12:30 or 1 o'clock. So it would take 1 hour from Taipei to Hsinchu Science Park. We are going to see Hsinchu Science Park. And it take 1 hour. Maybe so. Suppose we leave here around 1 o'clock. Then we get there around 2 o'clock. Then we spend another two hours over there. Then leave Hsinchu maybe around 4 or 5 o'clock. Then come back to Taipei, and maybe around 6 or 7 o'clock. So any question? For side visit.
I was asking about side visit because I have a class.
Yeah, so
if,
so if you have class earlier or later, yeah, so suppose you have a class maybe 1, 2, 3 or 5:30 to 6.
6:30.
6:30, then you can try to come back earlier. Anyone has a class? Any else? Around 5:30? 5:30 to 6:30? No? 6:30? Yes. How many students have class? 6:30. Okay, we try to come back here before 6:30. Then maybe we leave earlier. Maybe 12. Maybe 12. 12:10. How about 12:30? Yeah, 12:30 is fine. So we can meet here around 12:30. Then try to come back here before 6:30. Okay? Yeah. Okay, so it's a you take a 5-6 hours from to visit Hsinchu Science Park. I think it's better. If you have some other class and you have something, you don't need to go. But it's better you go there. And you can see there are more than 400 company, big, very big company, like Acer, like ASUS, like TSMC, UMC, like AUO, making TFT LCD. Those are very big company. You should pay a visit. Okay, so you can get all the information, the PDF file from this internet. And if you want to review the video, actually you can go to the reference website. I try to learn some Chinese. Try to learn some Chinese. I mentioned that last week. There are more than 1.4 billion people speak Mandarin. So it's better to learn one more language. Because maybe later on you are going to do some business with the people in China or in Taiwan or in Singapore. In Singapore, you can speak Mandarin also. In Hong Kong, yeah. Anybody from Hong Kong? No? You can also use Mandarin when you go to Hong Kong. And in United States, some place I speak Chinese. in Chinatown or in LA, yeah, sometimes I went to some shop. I just speak Mandarin. Any question concerning this course? The last day to enroll or to register is September 24th, or I think this Friday. So try to do it before this Friday. If you have any problem, call me or go to International Affairs office. Ask them to help you to enroll this course. Something wrong, I think, for this course internet. System.
So you don't need a green card.
Oh, you don't need a green card. You just go to course selection system to take this course. If you have any problem before this Friday, come to me or go to see the people in International Affairs office.
Actually, the question must be, are flight technology like security? If I say I'm on the MRT and I have an easy card in my pocket, mm-hmm. could someone come up next to me with a device and take money off of it?
Mm-hmm. Take money?
Yeah, could they scan it and take
I don't. I think it's possible. But with that high tech, they don't want you a small amount of money. They want to big money. They want to go to you see some movie, they try to make a, try to steal billion dollars, not $100. No, you know, the high tech, yeah, we have one student, the major is in criminology. Which one? You? So you are going to FBI? her major is criminology, right? Criminology. So you graduated, you can go to the FBI. CIA. No, you know, with high tech, people will become easier to become illegal, like steal some people's information, become a hacker, right? Like WikiLeaks. Everybody know, right? WikiLeaks. Some people access. In United States, government office steal some classified information. That's illegal. But yeah, so now many countries try to do something to prevent this high-tech criminal behavior. Yeah, but as you say, yeah, if some people invent or have some this high tech, they can maybe they can easier to get your money from your smart car, but that's too cheap. They don't want to do that. Okay.
Asking in Canada, what credit cards are you using? They're using it like the smart card, or
yeah.
They just scan it.
Yeah.
And then lately, there's some people that actually have, I don't know what they're doing, but they actually walk by you.
Mm-hmm.
Your
yeah. And last year I went to United States. One day I went to one store. Then I want to buy something. Then the cashier said my credit card is not valid. Then I called from United States. I called the credit card company in Taiwan. His one lady said, oh, my credit card was illegally used in New Zealand. You should be more careful. Yeah, maybe later, yeah. Okay, I think it's time to conclude today's class. So see you next week. Next week, we are going to talk about defense and technology next week. OK, see you next week.